Top 15 finance books everyone should read. Warren Buffett, possibly the greatest investor of all time, claimed that reading 500 pages each day was the secret to his success. Reading is the best way to increase your knowledge, and this is probably why many important personalities in the business world have made reading a daily ritual. So today, we are going to tell you guys about the top 15 finance books that all of you should read. So get ready to fortify your finance, to fortify your future. Number 1, Napoleon Hill, Think and Grow Rich. This book serves as the foundation for all subsequent business books. The title of this book, as well as much of the text, is about increasing revenue. The book's ideology, according to the author, may help people excel in any line of work and be anything they want to be. Napoleon Hill was Andrew Carnegie's protege. He was one of the wealthiest persons in history. This masterpiece of a book is the result of 20 years of research into a wide range of people who have amassed personal fortunes and the common features they share. Don't let the fact that it's an older book deter you. The information and knowledge within its pages are eternal, and you should definitely give it a read if you want to get somewhere in life. Number 2. Money Master the Game. Earning money isn't the only thing that you should be worried about. You should also focus on what you need to do with that money. This is the part where this book becomes so relevant. Tony Robbins may be the world's wealthiest self-help guru right now. Regardless of how you feel about him, Money Master the Game is a fantastic book that we strongly suggest. If you live in a developed country, notably the United States, you must read this book. The book deconstructs and simplifies the process of protecting one's financial future in a way that everybody can comprehend. The beauty of it is that the advice doesn't only come from Tony, but from experts who are at the top of their game when it comes to wealth management. These experts include people like Dalio, who you would have never been able to meet otherwise. Tony is using the contacts he's made throughout his life to share the techniques of the ultra wealthy. Number 3, Atlas Shrugged. Atlas Shrugged by Ayn Rand is the perfect read for people on holiday. Although this might be a controversial writer for some people, those people don't really know what they're talking about. So pay no heed to them. Mark Cuban's favorite book is this one. That's what he says in it. You'll learn everything you need to know about becoming a successful person. Ayn Rand's novel, Atlas Shrugged, is not a business book. It's a mystery, romance, and science fiction novel. It explains Ayn Rand's breakthrough, objectivism ideology. So, go on and get the book. You'll either love it or despise it. There's no middle ground here. But we would recommend that you should definitely give this book a read. Number 4, The E-Myth. This book debunks common misconceptions about starting a business. Common assumptions, expectations, and even technical expertise, according to the author Michael E. Gerber, can come in the way of running a successful firm. Gerber takes you through the stages of a firm's existence and shows you how to apply franchising ideas to any business. Whether it's a franchise or not, most significantly, Gerber distinguishes between working on your business and working in your business, which is a crucial distinction that is often neglected. Number 5, Blue Ocean Strategy. The international bestseller calls into question everything you thought you understood about what it takes to be a success in business. Companies have competed head-to-head since the dawn of the industrial age in search of long-term lucrative growth. They've pushed for a competitive edge, fought for market share, and struggled to stand out. These hallmarks of competitive strategy, however, are not the way to produce profitable growth in the future. As this famous, widely read book demonstrates, W. Chan Kim and Renee Marborn argue in their international bestseller, Blue Ocean Strategy, that ruthless competition leads to a violent red ocean of rivals, fighting over a decreasing profit pool. The authors claim that long-term success comes from developing blue oceans. Untapped new market sectors primed for growth, based on a study of 150 strategic actions, covering more than 100 years across 30 industries. Such strategic efforts, dubbed value innovation, by the authors result in significant value leaps that frequent render competitors obsolete for more than a decade. Number 6, the intelligent investor. Benjamin Graham, the best investing counselor of the 20th century, taught and inspired individuals all over the world. Since his first publication in 1949, Graham's idea of value investing, which protects investors from significant error and encourages them to construct long-term strategies, has made the intelligent investor the stock market Bible. Number 7, the hard things about hard things. Ben Horowitz, the co-founder of Addressing Horowitz and one of Silicon Valley's most respected and experienced entrepreneurs, draws on his personal experience founding, running, selling, buying, managing, and investing in technology companies in The Hard Thing About Hard Things to offer essential advice and practical wisdom for navigating the toughest problems business schools don't cover. His counsel is based on the experience from his own difficult journey, from co-founding the early cloud service provider LoudCloud to founding the tremendously successful venture capital firm Dressing Horowitz. Number 8, how to win friends and influence people. Do you ever feel that you are never taken seriously by others? Do you think you can't make successful relationships? Well, then it's time to read How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. This is another timeless masterpiece. Dale Carnegie's masterpiece deconstructs the basics of human behavior and what it takes to make others like you. You'll learn how to deal with people, pique their interest in you. You'll learn how to persuade them to agree with you and how to counter them without offending them. Also included is advice on how to be happier at home. It may appear to be a lot. However, this is one of those books that will be useful in everyday life until robots take over. Number 9, Lean In. Whether or not you agree with Sandberg's beliefs on gender and society, Lean In is a must-read for everyone interested in contributing to the discussion on women in leadership. She examines how women can unwittingly sabotage their professional advancement in the book, which mixes engaging research with personal emotional anecdotes. She also provides advice to both women and men who want to help women advance in their careers. It's a book that will make readers of both genders rethink their ideas about what it takes to succeed and be happy at work. Number 10, The Outsiders. 8 Unconventional CEOs and Their Radically Rational Blueprint for Success. What characteristics distinguish a successful CEO? A seasoned manager with considerable industry understanding. Most people think of when they hear the term. Others can refer to the characteristics of today's celebrity CEOs, such as charm, virtuoso, communication abilities, and a self-assured management style. But what actually matters when you're in charge of a company? What distinguishes great CEO performance? Simply said, it is the long-term returns on the investment for the company shareholders. As the name suggests, this book is the ultimate playbook for how CEOs drive their companies towards success. Number 11, The $100 Startup. Ever wanted to start a business but lack the funds? Well, this is the ultimate guide to starting a successful business with low startup costs. The $100 Startups book was essential in our early days. Thus, we decided to include it on this list. The book explains how to start a profitable business for less than $100. There have been a lot of successful firms that didn't start with a lot of money. There are plenty of case studies in the book, and the author doesn't mess around and gets directly to the point. This is a fantastic book for you to read that will help you grow. Number 12, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. Despite making a lot of money, you have this feeling. You're dissatisfied. Now that your investments and businesses are up and running successfully, it's time to consider the later stages of a firm. Raman Sharma does an outstanding job of explaining why money does not bring happiness and what to do about it in this book. If you previously achieved success, yet you're unhappy or dissatisfied in your life, this is the book you've been looking for. Number 13, The 10X Rule. Only difference between success and failure. Grant Cardone is a fascinating character. We enjoy his writings because he usually gets right to the point. No fancy words or hidden techniques. Just pure American muscle. We mean sales when we say American muscle. He's well known for his sales closing skills, an ability that has helped him get to where he is now. The 10X Rule is a kind of book that makes a lot of sense, but you might be hesitant to put it into practice because you're too lazy. The perfect time to read this book is when you think that your business is no longer growing. Number 14, 0 to 1. PayPal plans were founded by Peter Thiel. If you haven't heard of one, you have undoubtedly heard of the other. In the new economy, he made billions. This is a quick read, so whether it's simple to get through, don't underestimate it. Its contents hit all the right notes and will change the way you think about the world. This book is based on a lesson he had taught at Stanford University's master's degree. There are classes that we are proud to have taken. It focuses on the future, the current situation of the startup sector, and the industries that will be disrupted next. Number 15, Millionaire Fastlane. Is mediocrity's financial plan? A dream-stealing, soul-sucking dogma known as the slow lane? Your strategy for building wealth? You know the drill. Go to school, get a job, save 10% of your paycheck, buy a used car, cancel the movie channel, stop drinking pricey Starbucks mocha lattes, save and penny pinch your life away. Put your life savings in the stock market, and one day, you'll be wealthy. The mainstream financial gurus have duped you into adopting something you don't even need. There's an expressway to incredible fortune that can burn a trail to financial freedom faster. Any route out there for individuals who don't want a lifetime subscription to settle for less, and a slim possibility of rich retirement. This MJ DeMarco book is well less known than the others. However, we wanted to include it because it openly criticizes all the popular literature. It highlights his personal story, and may be the best tactic for individuals who believe going big, going home is the only way to proceed. We strongly advise you to take a look at this. We're going to do a part two for this video, so let us know which books we should add in the second video in the comments below. This video has been sponsored by Audible, and you can get their audiobooks by following the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do hit the bell icon on your way out. See you soon in the next video.